Hello, is this thing on? Hello, internet? Hello, come in. Over. Hey, everybody. It's Monday, and I'm streaming. Cats and Dogs Living in Sin, The End of Days. Yeah, it's Monday. I was going to stream yesterday, Saturday night. I thought I might be streaming yesterday, which was Sunday, but it didn't happen. I had other stuff going on. So here we are Monday. A little Fallout 3 with Nora the Vaultborn. How's everybody doing? Looks like it's been forever since I've talked to you guys, and it's only been a couple days. Yeah, if today's any indication, it's going to be a long, hot, and humid week. Yep, another scorcher here in the Northeast USA, and a lot of nice breeze coming through my windows, except it's all hot air. It's literally like standing behind a jet engine with the exhaust coming out. So, yeah, it's wonderful. But I hope everybody's doing well and staying safe and healthy and sane and all that good stuff. We're going to play the Fallout 3s tonight, continuing with Nora the Vaultborn. Although she really wasn't born in a vault. I don't have a whole lot to banner about, so I'm actually just going to get the game loaded up here. We can catch up on what I've been doing since the last time we played. I did do a little bit of inventory maintenance there at the Underground Hideout. Hey, Deckard, how you doing? Deckard 811. And BB, how you doing? Alright, yeah, that should be the last save there. Okay. Now my chair wants to eat the microphone. The headset cable, rather. So yeah, Underground Hideout, we're here in the armory. And of course, there's the Doge. Mr. Doge Meat. Yeah, I did a whole bunch of inventory maintenance since the last stream. I propped pretty much everything that we've been using in our main player home base. The mini hideout up in Springvale. Everything fine on your side. Good to hear. Glad you're doing well. Yeah, it feels like it's been forever since we've been together. Deckard, I saw your new little mod patch thingy for my player homes up on the Nexus. That's pretty cool. Seems like a lot of people are going to appreciate that. That was pretty cool that you went and did that. So yeah, I moved pretty much everything out of the mini hideout. I forgot to get the... actually, no, I don't have any left. I was going to say I forgot to get the pre-war books, but I forgot I gave everything I had to Scribe Yearling over at the Arlington Library last time around. So I think we're going to start storing those here. I did leave the Nuka-Cola Quantums up there because once... I didn't see the sense in dragging them all the way down there. This is closer to Girdershade than where we are here at the Underground Hideout, so... Hey, Kelly, we really gotta stop meeting like this, Kelly. I agree. People are gonna start talking. People will say things. And yell at us with mean, mean words. How you doing, Kelly? Good to see ya. Welcome back, Mr. Cotter. So no real plant... Well, actually, I do have a plant tonight. That's not exactly true. Go over that since I have the map open, and then we'll kind of take a tour through what I've done in the Underground Hideout here. Since we're so close to Jefferson Memorial, I thought we would start off by at least doing the first stage of scientific pursuits. Look for dear old dad in Project Purity's control room, which is oddly enough located pretty much right next to the Underground Hideout, Jefferson Memorial. We cleared out the super mutants that were on the outside. We'll just have to go clear them out on the inside. I don't think there's a whole lot in there. Like maybe five or six and a couple centaurs, I think. Some turrets, if I remember correctly. Once we do that, I want to head over to Anacostia Crossing and make our way through the metro. Because if you remember from the last stream, we kind of took the land route over to Rivet City. We walked past the Citadel, went over and cleared out Arlington Library. Did part of the Wasteland Survival Guide quest for the lovely and talented Miss Moira Brown in Megaton. Turn that into her. She gave us, what's the next one we're going to do here? I think it's the Robco facility. Yeah, we'll probably save that for next time around. I want to go through the metro kind of the reverse way that the game intends you to go. And I've done this before. It's kind of fun going bass-ackwards through the server. Through the metro. I'm thinking sewer and said server, but it's metro. The underground, the subway. Backwards, maybe if we get lucky, we'll find our way up to the Museum of Natural History, which is right down the street from the National Archives, which we have to go to for the Stealing Independence quest. Again, that's probably a couple streams away. But we can find our way to the surface there, at least pick up the National Archives marker. And I do have a player home installed, just basically a room that you can sleep in. I think there's a My First Infirmary, a couple other things in there. In the Natural History Museum, but that's right there. The end goal is to end up back over here near our subway base on this side of the river. And then I want to go up to Greyditch, which is somewhere up in this area, and do those quest. The quest with Brian Wilkes and the ants. Or as his father, he says his father called them those fucking ants. I think the kid says, his father says they were the stupidest fucking ants he'd ever seen. So we're going to go shoot the antenna on the fucking ants if we can get up there. Because I want to get Dr. Lesko's lab coat. I was looking at that today in the Fallout 3 wiki. And it apparently gives the largest science boost in the game. I think it's a plus 10 science and plus 20 rad resistance. Because right now, I think all I have is the lab uniform I got from Vault 101. I almost said 111. Vault 101 only gives a plus 5. And I think we're doing okay for science right now. Let's actually go over the stats here, and then we'll get... I'll give you the grand tour of what I've done in the hideout so far. Nora is at level 8. We have about another 1,000 points or so. Maybe a little less to get up to level 9. Special skills currently, strength of 8, perception of 5, 5 endurance, 8 charisma, 9 intelligence, 5 agility, and 4 for luck. And that would normally be 3, but I got the lucky 8 ball from Time Bomb up in Big Town. And as long as I have the lucky 8 ball in my inventory, I get a plus 1 for luck, so... Luck is sitting at a pretty measly 4 right now. No particular build for this character, just playing the game for the fun of it for the first time in many, many years. But I do seem to be putting a lot of points in the small guns, repair, and speech. Those are my biggies right now. I do want to start pumping some into energy weapons. I want to start using energy weapons. So, Nora's father is a scientist, and she's kind of getting the science bug. Thinks energy weapons are cool, so I think I might want to start putting some points into energy weapons, and that's pretty much where we are. Yeah, repair is up to 60, and science isn't doing. I would like to get science up to 50 if we level up this time around, but we are of course. Whoops, that's not what I want to do. Of course, we've already seen we're traveling Mr. Dogmeat, the one and only Bittercup, who's still not dead yet, unfortunately. And, of course, the grizzly old Jericho, who I did go and purchase a combat helmet for. Both Jericho and Bittercup are sporting the Talon Company combat armor, just because we've run into so many Talon Company guys that I had plenty of it laying around. Science, bitch! Yes. And there's Nora. There's our girl Nora. She's really, really come a long way since leaving the vault. She's got a pretty cool outfit... she got here. What the hell is this thing called? Looted it off a wastelander up near Super Duper Mart. The Wasteland Looter, which is part of the NPC's travel. Gives me a plus 20 carry weight and a plus 5 small guns. And it looks like I probably need to repair it here too. Also gonna go with the Wasteland Soldier Helmet, which I think actually both of these need to be repaired here. It looks like. Yeah. Okay, so we got that. Weapons, we have, I should probably check these out too, the 10mm submachine gun, the Chinese assault rifle, hunting rifle, a sniper rifle, which definitely needs to be repaired, and I should have combat shotgun, which that also needs to be repaired, so I think we're in good shape now. Everything is repaired, so let me catch up on Jay or Deckard. Did most of them by myself and thought... do is release the rest of them on Nexus and other people. Yeah, seems like there's already been a few people that have that have responded positively, so good luck with those. Indominus, Indominus Rex Tyrant, I just saw you there. Hello, welcome, good to see you. So yeah, I brought pretty much all the inventory down from Springvale. I ran the weapons and clothing and whatnot through the sorter. So this is the weapons wall so far. Got the 10mm pistol, 10mm submachine gun. These are all duplicates. A lot of them are Chinese pistol. I'd like to get one of every weapon in the game at some point, even if I don't use it, like the melee weapons that I'll never use. Laser pistol, laser rifle, and a missile launcher. And I have multiples of some of these. So yeah, at some point I would like to get every weapon in the game on the wall. More for over there. And I think custom-built weapons. Oh, this is, yeah, this is where you can put the weapons that you can build with the blueprints. Dart gun, rocket launcher, which is essentially like the junk jet in Fallout 4. Railway rifle, the shish kebab, death call gauntlet. I've never actually built any of these. So maybe I'll try doing that at some point. I did sort out all the crafting material that you need to build those are all there. Rocket launcher materials. I offhand, don't ask me what you need to build each weapon, but I'm going to try taking advantage of the sorting system here because it's pretty cool. And we have weapon walls for all the DLC weapons over here. Anchorage, Broken Steel, Mothership Zeta.
They stand in long enough for us to leave.
Oh, Jericho, this place is perfectly fine. I sorted the ammunition I have, which isn't actually a whole lot. Not as much as I thought it was. Don't ask me where I got alien power cells from already. I think those might have already been here. Because we haven't done Mothership Zeta yet, so I don't know why there's alien power cells here. But 10mm rounds, 32, my 44, which I don't have.
I just need to catch my breath.
Oh, you're standing still, Jericho. Quit with the chain smoking. Energy cells, microfusion cells. The cool thing with this, it's the same as the New Vegas version that we've been using. Use the sorter. You can sort the ammunition in the containers. And then once it's sorted into the containers, you hit stock shelves. And it will actually put predetermined amounts. Like I think each one of these is 12. So I probably could just take all the ammo since ammo doesn't weigh anything. But I think it's kind of cool to have some sitting there. And yeah, so oh, there's one other thing that... did you guys see that? Did you see that? The power of Todd compelled dog meat to defy gravity and actually fly. I don't know if you guys caught that or not. Lone Ponder says, I like that name, that's pretty awesome. That's a great name, Lone Ponder. Say this ship has crashed, it sends alien power cells all over the area, maybe picked up by luck. I think those were here as part of the mod, I'm guessing. Because Mothership Zeta is already here. All I have to do is, oh, actually, I have, no! In the vanilla game, you automatically get the radio signal, the beacon, in the Pip-Boy. And if you activate the signal, that starts the quest. It gives you the map location for the crashed ship. I actually have a mod installed that doesn't do that. You have to be in a specific part of the map in a specific area for the signals to pop up, and we must have been somewhere. Tyrant King Xenomorph. Say that 10 times fast. Thanks for that follow and welcome. We've already been somewhere where we picked up Warner's distress signal. I have no idea where that was. And I'm pretty sure that starts the Pit DLC. I think most of those... Yeah, see, those aren't even in my... DLC quests are not even in the quest log yet. So I actually have to listen to the radio. But the mod, I think it's like... oh, Christ, what the hell is it? It's in my mod list. I can't remember the name of it. But it basically delays... It hides all the radio signals so you can't just stumble across them. Glad to be here. Glad to see you here. Appreciate you stopping in. Hanging out. Yeah, so that's it. There's shotgun shells. It's pretty cool. But wait, there's more. If we head down into the armor display wing, I started decking out the mannequins. I don't have a lot of outfits here yet. But that Outcast power armor that we put Bittercup in a while back, that's there. Vault security suit and Vault 101 jumpsuit, just for old time's sake. But everything else is empty right now. But just like the mannequins in... Fallout 4 and Skyrim, you can equip them with whatever you want. And then for whatever reason, there's a little bit of a lag before they re-render with the new outfit. This is another display room, but you have to manually put things here. So yeah, we're not gonna do anything with those right now. So that's pretty much it. That's, looks like I got some 308s. Oh, I'm gonna take all my 308s with me. Clean out of 308s now. Stock 44, stock 308. Yeah, I think that's... Yeah, you have to have even amounts for them to show up on the stock shelves. Like, if I open up the 32s, I've got 4. I think you got to have multiples of 12 for them to actually stock on the shelf. Like, there's only 3. I might as well just take these. And I might just take these two. Oh, there's one more thing I wanted to show you guys. I actually found this yesterday when I was in here seeing where I was with things. Yeah, this little Brotherhood of Steel thing on the floor here. I didn't realize this was actually a hatch to the simulation room. Yeah. Came from YouTube, what kind of character are you playing? This is not really a specific character. We are playing, her name's Nora. She's the Vaultborn, even though she really wasn't born in a vault. At least that's what she's learning to find out. No particular build. This is first time I played the game in ages, so... we are going to be specializing, it seems like, small guns, repair, and speech right now are pretty much what I've been dumping points into for skills. No particular build, kind of just a generic character. I haven't played the game long enough to really have a specific build in mind, so just playing it to play it and have some fun. Oh. So this is apparently a simulator room. Oh, there's a light switch over here. That's why it's damn dark. Let's turn the lights on. I didn't know this was here. I have no idea what you got to do to get this thing working, but there's a simulation mainframe, and it's currently non-functional.
When I'm gone, I'll be sure to haunt this place.
But there's these mainframe interface, neural interface suit. I'm going to have to figure out what this is and how it works, but I'm going to assume it's an Operation Anchorage kind of thing. I have no idea. I had no idea this was here. Yeah, it's activated. It says currently non-operational. Any kind of backstory you made or just ran? Well, it's Fallout 3. You start off in Vault 101. Your father leaves the vault. That's pretty much your backstory. If you've never played Fallout 3 before, you start off in Vault 101, and your father is a scientist. And one day, he leaves the vault. We started off in Vault 101. And we are on a quest to find dear old dad, and Trail is here. So, yeah, if you've only played Fallout 4, your objective is to find your son. Fallout 3, your objective is to find your dad. So, no backstory other than we're from a vault, and we're looking for our dad. Because that's how the game is written. We'll head back into the underground hideout here. What kind of mods am I using? Well, the description, the title of the stream should have a little command you can type in, exclamation point mods. But right there, that's to the mod list. Nothing that changes too much as far as gameplay goes. Just some quality of life mods. Graphics overhauls, player homes, because I love the player homes, and it's all there. Food is sorted out here. Actually, didn't have a whole lot of food to sort. Junk food, because there's a food sorting system as well, and it comes fully stocked with some things here already. Because remember, the place did have previous occupants. That's how we got the place. We tracked down Jonathan, I think his name was. Convinced him not to throw himself off a cliff. So I think these are empty. Yeah, these are all empty. So as we start collecting more Nuka-Cola Quantums, I'll start storing them here. I'm going to have to get the ones up in Oh, what the hell am I saying? One's up in Springvale, back at the other player home. So we got the bathroom in there. And I think we're in good shape. No rads. Our health is in good shape. And I don't know if I showed this to you guys before. The terminal. You can actually order things. There's an ordering center. It's kind of like how the one in New Vegas works. You can order from the Crimson Caravan. For this one, you could order from the caravans over at Rivet City. And if you were to order weapons, there's all these different things you can order here. Handgun. Actually, if I needed to order some 5.56, here's ammunition. If I ordered 300 5.56 rounds, at 7 a.m. the next morning, there'd be a caravan out in front of the bunker entrance. And I could pick up my stuff from them. You pay your caps through the terminal. 7 a.m. the next morning, you meet the caravan out front. But if you leave before that, they're over at Rivet City. It's pretty cool. Order the Wazer Wifle. I can order a Wazer Wifle, but the Wazer Wifle I have to go to get from Billy and Widow Lamplight. It's actually going to be getting dark here pretty soon, so... Come on, Jericho. So I think we should get everybody. Yes, we do. All right. I think we should be able to head over and we'll do the first part of just to, for those of you who just joining us, we're going to start out doing scientific pursuits. Look for Dad and Project Purity's control room, which is right over there in the Jefferson Memorial. And then we're going to go take a little spin through my favorite part of Fallout 3, the Metro, the subway system. Because it's fun and confusing, and I'm probably going to get lost because I'm going to be going the opposite direction that the game wants you to go. And there's those trees popping in. Love that popping. So we already cleared the super mutants out from outside of Jefferson Memorial, so I wonder if these guys over here respawned yet. Nope, not yet. No muties over there yet. Well, that's a happy thing. Oh. No. That one. Speaking of Metro, have you ever played a Metro game, Decker Das? I've played the first Metro, maybe 3 or 4 hours of it. And just kind of lost interest. I just couldn't get into it. I have the Redux of 2033 and Last Light, and I haven't installed them.
Oh, hurry up! I have poetry I need to write.
They were cool. I mean, they look really awesome, but I just couldn't get into them for whatever reason. I will try them again at some point. Like when I got this new machine, I had totally intended on trying the Redux, because I did like the performance test and everything, but I just never did. Oh.
You want some of this?
Bitter cup. Where are those?
Oh, hell yeah!
Centaur over here? Oh, yeah.
I'm gonna fuck you!
Hey!
Man, I just...
Oh, I tried to get my shotgun out and you guys are taking my kills. You're just gonna have nail boards. Let's go kill the rest of them here. And then we'll go loot the rest of the things. There are other things to loot. Deckard says, had the same, but after some time I got into them, and afterwards I even read the books. Yeah, I'd like to read the books. I actually would like to read the books. Holy shit! I one-shotted the Super Mutant with my shotgun. I couldn't do that again if I tried.
It was nothing.
A noise! Wow.
Damn it.
What is the damage on this thing? Holy Christmas. 39. Huh. Okay. These guys must not have a whole lot of damage resistance on them, then. Yeah, I've enjoyed watching other people play the Metro games. I just haven't felt compelled to want to get back into them myself. Actually, I'm going to take that. We can go sell that. Maybe we'll have time. It's 7 o'clock already. We may just want to wait till morning. Sleep over at the hideout. Go sell some stuff at Rivet City in the morning. Because the shops are going to close in an hour. So we don't need to go down there yet. I'm not going to bother with that yet. Or is that... Oh, the Rotunda? No, we need to go to the Rotunda. I'm thinking the basement. There's a basement here too, but... We do need the Rotunda. And there's going to be another couple of them in here, I think. One up here? No. But we do need to go... Here and here. Listen to Dad's personal entry number 10. Alright, I think that we need to clear out. There's at least... Yeah, there's two more super mutants here. Do companion die in this, or do you have an essential mod? I have an essential mod on. Vanilla Fallout 3, your companions will die. And I did not know that the first time I played this, because I came from playing New Vegas the first Fallout game. And when Dogmeat died, my first time playing this game, it broke my heart. I could not bear to lose my dog, so... Went, reloaded the save, and after that, Where the hell did he go? Is he up there? I hear the... Ah! I was just up there! Where the hell were you? Are you getting bored, Bittercup? Well, we'll fix that. Rafflecopter plays. Thanks for that follow. Welcome. Yeah, after Dogmeat died, I went and found a mod that made the Masachi want reloaded the save because I could not stand losing my dog. Yeah, and I know that there's a perk you can get from Broken Steel that Dogmeat can have puppies, but it's not the same. Because none of your other companions can have puppies, they just dead and gone. And the mod that I'm using to make the companions essential also makes all the traveling caravanners essential, so they don't die. Because I've had that happen more than once, and that's frickin' annoying. I think we're good here. So we have to listen to Dad's personal journal entry number 10. So let's go and listen to that.
I'm off to Vault 112 to search for anything of bronze that might help me get this purifier up and running. All I know is that it's west of some place called Evergreen Mills, and it's well hidden in some sort of garage. But I'll find it. I have to. It's so close, but that's the story of Project Purity, isn't it? An eternity of almost theirs. Let's see if Braun has the missing puzzle piece.
Okay, so, dear old Dad is in Vault 112. I don't think that, actually does give you a location. Yeah, that's up here. It's actually hidden in this place, I think it's Smith Casey's garage. We're not going to do that right now, we're just going to turn that right off. I have a mod that lets you deselect quests. Normally you can't. It's not too far from Girdershade, which is kind of this area here. And that's where we can pick up. We can meet Sierra Petrovita. You might recognize that name from the Fallout 4's Nuka World DLC. Well, that's where she's from. She's up here in Girdershade. And we'll get a quest to collect, I think it's 30 Nuka-Cola Quantums for her. Well, that's going to be a while. Oh, we gotta go and loot the front here. This is... Yeah, that's the basement. We'll go deal with the basement much, much later. I think there's anything here we need, right? Nope. And it's empty. Where's the entrance? You I looted already. Ooh, more shotgun shells. Anything we can actually sell or use. Let's see, ammo, of course. I'm so not used to, oh, we got a sensor module. I can sell that conductor. 5.56. Now, just keep in mind the sensor modules we find. We can take those over to the Outcast, the Brotherhood Outcast, over at Port Independence and trade those in for 5.56 ammo. Because they're practically junk. We might be making a trip over there. I had some of those. Sensor modules. Did Jericho have sensor modules? Where are you? Oh, I almost didn't see this.
What are we standing around here for when there's plenty of action around?
I am also using a mod that bypasses the karma checks for companions, because Fallout 3 has a karma system. And normally to recruit Jericho, I'd have to have an evil karma. But I don't. I'm a goody two-shoes. So I can recruit any companion I want. Because I like the karma system, I don't have a problem with it, but when it comes to recruiting companions, especially like Jericho here, who's kind of a grizzled old merc slash raider, he wants you to pay him 1,000 caps. Shouldn't matter what my karma is if I'm paying you to come along, bud.
Sure, give me whatever.
Yeah, he has two sensor modules, so I'm actually going to give those to him. I have 4 scrap metal. The scrap metal I can either sell to Walter up in Megaton or use it to repair my gear. The bent tin cans, I've been using those, and...
Yeah, let's get to the action.
Pre-war money, Wonder Glue. I can use those to repair my gear thanks to the BA repair mod, because normally in the game they're kind of useless. Let's see, Deckard says, speaking of Sierra, just started Nuke World today, haven't played it for ages. I actually haven't played it. It's been probably almost 2 years since I played it. I have a test character for my Let's Play series. I actually started that recently, just to make sure all the mods I'm using are working before I go there in the Let's Play over on YouTube. So, went through the gauntlet a few months ago and kind of haven't done anything else, so... Tyrant King Xenophros checking YouTube New Vegas run. How does it take to get to Willow? Not too far. I mean, she's I'd say she's about I would say halfway between Good Springs and the old Mojave Outpost. Probably closer to Mojave Outpost. I don't think she's too far from Prim. I think she's just down the road from Prim. So you can absolutely leave Good Springs and make a straight beeline for Prim and go meet up with her. How long time-wise? It just depends on how you play the game. I mean, you can literally go from Good Springs and run right down to Prim in probably 10 minutes. And you can go get Willow. It's all up to you. All depends on how you play the game.
Hang on. I just need to catch my breath.
Alright, so we're gonna go sleep. Because obviously it's pretty dark out. Although, oh. We're in here. I mentioned last stream that Rivet City looks pretty awesome at night. And you probably can't see it from way the hell down here, but... Yeah, I think once we get closer, the lights on the tower and everything are all kind of lit up. It looks pretty cool. But I think we're too far away for them to render, so... I'm not going down that way. We're gonna go sleep. The morning we'll stop by Rivet City, sell some of the stuff I just looted from the Super Mutants, maybe buy some more ammo or something, and hit the Metro.
This is lame.
It is not lame, Bitter Cup. We're just getting started. Sometimes they just stay there. They don't come down. So, looks like it's what they're going to do here. Here's my bedroom. Alright, let's see. That would be 10-20, 9-20, 8-20. That sounds good. I'll have to make a save here, too. Bitter Cup is very emo. She has to write poetry. dark poetry. Okay, I have auto saves and everything turned off, so because you don't wanna rely on those. They can really screw up your game. I think that's what happened in my last game. Yeah, I don't know, for some reason, sometimes they follow me right down and sometimes they just stay right there. Same thing at the mini bunker, the mini hideout there in Springvale. Sometimes they follow me right down into the inside, sometimes they stay by the loading door. How long does it take your play? Like I said, depends how you play the game. You can just go right there and pick her up. You have to do some quests before she's an actual companion, but it all depends on how you want to do it. There's no set time. I can't give you a time. It depends on how you play the game. It's all up to you how long it takes. You could completely ignore the main quest, ignore the main game, and just do stuff for Willow. That's probably the quickest way to get her as a companion. Because it's not just go, "Hi, I'm Willow. Wanna be my friend?" No, you have to actually do some stuff for her before she's actually a companion. I would say that part maybe takes maybe an hour, maybe less. Again, depends on how you play the game. Depends on what you do.
Ugh, hurry up. I have poetry I need to write. Dark poetry.
There she goes with the dark poetry. How many episodes of my live stream series before I get? Oh, I have no idea. I can't answer that. That was well over a year ago, and I can't remember what I had for lunch 3 days ago, so I have no idea. Can't answer that.
Yes.
Yeah, so this is delivery bomb, and if I had ordered stuff from the underground hideout, I could come over here to get these guys, or if I was out there at 7 a.m., they would be outside. So. Yeah, sorry, Tyrant King, I didn't understand what you were at. I thought you meant how long in the game. How many videos? I don't know. I have no idea. I started my New Vegas playthrough well over a year ago, so I have no idea when it was.
Ugh, hurry up. I have poetry
Again with the poetry, Bittercup. Well, wait till we get Sydney. You can write poetry for her. Alright, we're just gonna go to Flak and Shrapnel.
Yes?
Welcome to... This here is Flak and Shrapnel's gun shop. Pretty catchy, huh? Take a look around. If you see anything you like, I'll be right over here.
Okay. Let's see. It's quite a selection, but they're all in lousy condition.
I don't put the good stuff out on the table. If you're interested, I can show you the stuff in the locker.
Really? Have you ever heard of a guy named Pinkerton?
You mean Genius Boy? Yeah, I've heard of him. Supposedly built Rivet City. They probably think he invented bread, too. Idiots. Lately, he's even been blamed for the noises in the broken ship bow. Anyone with half a brain would know that's just the Mire Lurks.
Alright, so can I see what kind of guns you have for sale?
Need to do some killing, eh?
Flapping Cracknell. let's see. I'm going to hang on to most of the ammo because obviously ammo doesn't weigh anything, so no point in getting rid of it. I will sell the pistol. I don't need all the... I don't know which of these is my good hunting rifle. Only one of those. I'll keep one of those to repair mine with, and I think that's all. I pretty much sold all my junk and whatnot already. The sheet music book. We discovered the sheet music book in the Arlington Library last time, and I did look it up. Yes, I do not want to sell that. There's one in the Arlington Library, and there's like two or three other ones. If you give one of these to Agatha, the woman we have to go find a violin for, she gives you a special weapon. Or she has the potential to give you a special weapon, a unique named weapon. So we're not going to sell the sheet music book. I think there's only like 3 or 4 of them in the game. I think there's maybe 3 of them. Maybe it's 4. I can't remember. But yes, we don't want to sell the sheet music book. The conductor, yeah, we'll get rid of those because those are heavy. And I think that's it. I think we're pretty good for ammo. When we first got the sniper rifle, I had like 5 rounds for it, and I'm pretty well set there. I'm gonna grab all he has. They seem to not stock a whole lot of 308, so I'm gonna grab it when I can. 5.56. You know, I'm gonna buy some more 5.56. I'll buy half of what he has. Because we'll probably go through a bunch in the metro, and then we'll probably want to go say hello to the outcasts and turn in those sensor modules. 10mm, I think we're okay on. Yeah, I think we're set. We're good.
Another satisfied customer.
Oh, and by the way, did you know that Paulie Kentelli is an addict?
Yeah, he's totally strung out. It's going to kill him one of these days.
Oh, so you know all about it then. Okay. All right, thanks. I got to run.
If you need more ammo, this is where to get it.
Okay, I'm sure we'll be back.
Hello.
All right, so what does that do for my carry weight now? 190, we're good shape. All right, let's drop a save before we go back out into the world. And let's go down through the subway. This ought to be fun. I totally won't get lost. Totally won't get lost. Nope, Tyrant, you're fine. That's just a timer. It goes off every once in a while. You've done nothing wrong.
Hello?
Just gotta see what Doc Hoff has here.
Here to see the good doctor? Excellent.
Try not to die.
Try not to die.
And British lady's so calm about it. Thanks for those bits, Deckard. Appreciate it. Hey, Mad Dog, everything is my fault. Yes, when all else fails, blame Mad Dog. How you doing? Good to see you.
Tell me what you need, and maybe I've got your fix.
Mad Dog, I know you may find this hard to believe, but according to according to Bittercup, she has dark poetry to write. I know you might find that very difficult to believe, but yes, Bittercup needs to go write some dark poetry. Stimpaks. 58 Stimpaks. I think we're pretty good there. We've got to go find, what's his name? For the sugar bombs, we haven't discovered him yet. Yeah, I think we're good there.
Cheers, pal. Watch yourself out
Clips
there.
Clips or it never happened. Alright, let's... Sometimes Talon Company likes to wait for me here. Alright, so according to this You Are Here map that I've never used before, that's where we are now, in Anacostia Station. We want to end up over in this area here. So, at some point, we're going to have to come up, I think it's... Yeah, there's Museum of Technology, the History Museum Station. We want to go and poke our head above ground there and pick up the map marker. For when we go do Stealing Independence. Because the... Oh, come on. I'm having a brain fart here. National Archives is right around the corner from that, so... Does that map really work? Well, it's the first time I've used it. It's a texture overhaul for the subway maps, but there's another map that I use in conjunction with it that adds the You Are Here arrows, and I've never used it before, so if it actually works, I don't know. We'll find out. But yeah, all the subway maps now have one of those little arrows over it, which I think is a cool idea. I don't know how practical it's going to be and if it's actually going to work. As far as work as in, am I going to get lost or not?
Hang on. I just need to catch my breath.
I think there's raiders down here. Can't remember. Yep, I see a raider. Yep. Oh, I forgot. This isn't New Vegas. Wow. Alright. I thought I could take you out, but I guess not. Oh, they're very chatty. Yeah, I thought, for whatever reason, my sniper rifle just was not doing any damage to him.
I'm getting bored.
Bittercup is bored already. She's not happy unless she's shooting something. Oh, that's right, too. Yeah, New Vegas, I have, with Stewie's tweaks, I have it where the, I still have the zoom scopes on the sniper rifles, but I also have, if I have the shift key, I can hold my breath and steady my aim like in Fallout 4, but that's not part of the Stewie Sweets for Fallout 3, so I kind of got confused. It happens. Happens a lot, actually. Let me see, can I, how much is the purified water going to top me off here? Or do I have three ice cold, six ice cold Nuka-Colas. Let's take one of those bad boys. Mad Dog Fargo, thank you for that sub. I don't know why British Lady didn't read that, but thank you, sir. Appreciate that. Yeah, I could take that. Yeah, that sniper rifle should have just taken him out. Am I planning to use Fox? Oh, probably. Yep. Yeah, it's been so long since I played the game. I mean, there's Fox, there's Star Paladin Cross, and I don't even know that I think I may even use her one time. But I've only finished this game three times and only done the DLC once. And the last time I actually finished it was probably 2012 or 13. So, yeah, I definitely want to use Fox, though. Okay, I'm not hitting him at all. I'm actually hitting the rail. This isn't doing a whole lot of damage here. Yeah. Hmm. Already gonna be using stim packs. This is not what I was intending. I also don't have the weapon I wanted to use either, but got it, might as well use it. Let's grab some bent tin cans for the repairs.
This is lame.
It is not, Bittercup. Quit your bitching. Buff out. Oh, almost thought that was a stealth boy for a second. Okay, so I guess it's just the... Oh, no, there it is, right. Metro Central. That can't be right. We're at Anacostia Station. Why is that saying I'm there? Metro Central. That doesn't make any sense. I think that map is wrong. So, nope, I guess the map doesn't work. First station, it's already... We already found an error.
What the... Did I step in something?
British lady didn't say anything because she's not clever enough. Yeah, I don't know why she didn't talk for that. That's... That makes me very angry. I haven't played this in years myself, but when I did, my main companion was always Fox, Karen, and Dogmeat in a Deathclaw mod I made myself. Oh, cool. Yeah, Karen's another one I don't think I've ever used Karen at all. Maybe once, briefly? The last playthrough I attempted that I started last year, that I think the save files got corrupted for some reason. I was using RL3 for a while. Oh! It's good for unarmed. I've also got a mod installed that I absolutely love that makes Sydney from Stealing Independence into a companion. So we're gonna be getting Sydney at some point. But I'm not gonna travel with like 5 companions. That gets to be a little much. I'm gonna limit it to 2 plus dog meat. That's plenty. If he's like today's Karens, he's dangerous. let's make another save here before we go down. What's my... Yeah, the sniper rifle was not really doing much of anything. Here are the, Shotgun was taking out super mutants with like 1 and 2 shots, but that sniper rifle, well, maybe I was just not hitting them. I'm wondering if maybe the accuracy when I zoom in isn't what it should be. All right, northbound museum station. This is where we want to go. Man, all that was down here, really. I feel like we're missing something. I think that was it. Just the raiders. A lot of bent tin cans, though. Okay, there's nothing in here. Oh! I thought there needed to be more somebody's down here. We're not gonna go that way yet. That is southbound. We're not gonna go that way. Not right now. I thought that maybe this was a ticket booth we could go inside, but I guess not. So this way we go. I'm just going to take the one... Just this one bent tin cannon, I think I have enough for a while. That thunk was my glasses hitting the microphone. Sorry about that. Be looking for traps too, shouldn't I? I think we may have raiders up here. Yep. Good job, dog meat. Good boy. Got a lot of ammo. I'm probably gonna start giving some of this stuff to my faithful companions to carry my burdens. There's some stuff here we could be selling. Yes, please. I'll always gladly take a stim pack. Alright, do I have anything I can condense down? Mad Dog, thank you for that cheer. And again, British Lady is not working. I'm gonna have to go check British Lady. I'm gonna have to take a break here momentarily. I will go see what the hell is wrong with British Lady. Is she on strike? Thanks for those bits, Mad Dog. Hey, Grey Dog, how you doing? All the dogs here. Mad Dog, Grey Dog. How you doing? I don't know what's up with British Lady. I'm disappointed. I'm not enjoying my disappointment. Alright, Bitter Cup.
Oh, hey. I was just trying to think of a word that rhymes with gloom.
Let's trade some equipment.
Here. This is for you.
You can please carry my burdens. and make a save here. I am going to take a quick break, guys. I got to get a glass of water anyway, so I want to take a quick break. I'm going to get some water, and I'm going to check the Streamlabs thing, see why the voice-to-text or text-to-voice thing isn't working. Give me about 2 or 3 minutes. Give yourselves a little break there. Stretch the legs. Get some water. I definitely need some more water here. And we'll be back here exploring the Metro in Fallout 3. See you in just a few. Okay, we're back. Appreciate you guys hanging around. I did take a look at Streamlabs and everything seemed to be set up okay, so I guess just the voice, our lovely little British lady just doesn't want to do her thing tonight. Then Grey Dog, thank you for that sub there. Appreciate it.
I still work, I am just ignoring Mad Dog.
There she is. Thank you, Mad Dog, for those wonderful biddies. That's a good test. She seems happy with you now. Thank you, sir. I heard of the Baby Deathclaw Commander mod. No, I have not. Is that yours? You said you made a Deathclaw mod. Kelly, that's exactly what I did. I did unplug her and plug her back in. I disabled all the text-to-voice options and re-enable, just toggle them, turn them off and on again, and maybe that's what fixed her. But yes, I did. Oh, Maul Outpost. Okay, so this is... Oh, you get to... Uh-oh. That sounded like a silence weapon. This is how you get to the Brotherhood. Let's go see what's down here. So it'll show. Okay, that's not, I could have sworn she had a silence weapon. It did not sound like a shotgun. No, but you clear Quarry Junction and find a viable Deathclaw egg. Oh, that's kind of cool. Tyrant Zenov, you cannot post links unless you are a subscriber. That's... Nightbot is telling you there. Only subscribers can post links in chat. Okay, this is what I was thinking of, where there was more below for the raiders. Yeah, these chairs and everything here. That's what I was thinking of. Where are you?
You like that? Come out.
Come on, where are you?
Man.
Come on. Where the hell are they? Did you guys find them? Are they down here? I think there's maybe only one more. What the hell? Oh, this looks cool, but I can't see anything. Get them all. I think we got them all. Alright, let's go see what they had. Yes, please. Well, they don't have any weight. I'm gonna take them. Yes, take all those. Yeah, I'm going to start wanting to put some points into energy weapons, I think. Let's see, I can't use that. I did want to actually eat this book that I got earlier. It really won't help me, but a Pugilism Illustrated? Why not? Unarmed increase by 2. Might come in handy. Go this way. Grey Dog, thank you for gifting that sub. Oh, I'm sorry, Deckard. Thank you. Thanks to Deckard 811 for gifting that sub to Tyrant King Xenomorph. Tyrant King, enjoy that gift sub and go ahead and post your link. You should be able to now. Thanks, Deckard. No. I can't remember which weapons I have hotkeyed to what here. Oh, see, I thought... Alright. For some reason, I thought there was another raider and some red roaches. Maybe that's the other side. Right, so, to the mall. Let's drop a save here. Hey, Vic, how you doing? Good to see ya. This, where we want to be? And there's going to be shitloads of super mutants over here. Yes, there is. Two shits, kid. Two shits. Damn it, dinner cup. Oh, I've got to tell you guys a story here when we get done killing these guys. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Now, there's a face. There is a face. Check that out. The face of enjoying your disappointment right there, ladies and gentlemen. I'm gonna die here. I'm gonna die. It's not what I was expecting. I expected a few, but not this many. Oh shit, they got grenades. There's one down. Down here. Okay, he's down. Uh-oh, grenade. That really it? No, there's not. Come on, game, switch weapons. Damn. Yeah, we're saving after that. yeah, it's Fallout 3, we're saving after that. Holy Christmas. Okay, this is actually further up from where I thought we were gonna be. That's okay. I'm okay with that. I was expecting us to be... Museum of Technology. Yeah, where's the damn History Museum? I have to go pick up that map marker. I'm all confused. I think we gotta go further up. Wow. Yeah, that was not where I thought we were going to be coming out. Not at all. Not by a long shot. Bittercup's bored now. Holy jeez. Okay.
Goddamn cigarettes are getting harder to find.
Oh, Jericho and your cigarettes. Yeah, you had a minigun. Tell you what, let's take that. Jericho. Why don't you take this?
Yeah, what is it? Sure, give me whatever you got.
How about you take... Did I not take the minigun? Yes, I want to tell you a story. This little encounter reminds me of something
Yeah, kid, what do you need?
One of the things I was doing yesterday, once I realized I wasn't going to stream, because other stuff going on.
Sure, give me whatever you got.
I decided to do some more testing of the mod list in my new Fallout 4 playthrough. So I have a test character with essentially the same load order as what we've been streaming with, and decided it was time to go down to Quincy to check things out there, because we're going to have to go that way for a railroad quest. I really want to get reacclimated to it. Long story short, The gunners around the Cambridge police station, Tessa and a bunch of other ones, came out and attacked me and Heather, and I had tried with Nick Valentine at the time. Yeah, the gunners came out doing the gunner thing. And it's right by the house where Billy's parents live. Billy's friggin' parents came out. Billy's father picked up a plasma rifle off one of the dead gunners and started joining the fight. It was oh my god, I wish I was on Twitch and could clip it. It was beautiful. It was one.
Over here! Where?
It was. It was one of those Fallout 4 moments that you never in a million years would expect to ever happen, but it happened. Billy's parents coming over, taking the weapons off the dead gunners and joining the fight. And Billy's father walked off with a beautiful plasma rifle strapped to his back. It was glorious. Hey, Godosin, how you doing? Oh, yeah, I wasn't streaming at the time, though. I mean, this was like last night. I was just playing on my own. I can't see shit here. It's getting... Oh, Jesus, another one of the mini guns. Let's take out the arm with that, shall we? Shoot it out of his hand. Right. I know there's stuff down in the, their little trenches here, but we're not going to go there right now. I have enough hunting rifles. Doing well, Godosin. Thanks. A another scorcher here today. It's very humid, but we're all right. Oh, that's where we actually wanted to be, over there. Okay, Washington Monument. Even though this is a Brotherhood outpost, there's no Brotherhood here. I can hear the GNR radio. Until you do the three dog thing, there's actually nobody here. I meant to go back and get this map marker down here. Let's do that. Yeah, we're not going to do the three dog stuff yet until after we meet up with Dad. Because if you go find Dad first, three dog actually gives you a key to a stash up in Hamilton's Hideaway that I don't think I've ever done before. I don't think I've ever done it that way, so... We're going to hold up on saying hello to Three Dog anytime soon. Wanted to pick this up, though. I suppose we could go get the Virgo thing now, but we'll wait. Okay, yep. I just wanted to pick that up. Make sure the fan is on, but at least there's no tapeworm tonight. Oh, I got the AC going right now. Well, I got fans going now, but I will have the AC going as soon as I get off the stream here tonight. Plug up the AC in the bedroom, and all will be right with the world. Right, we actually came out on the wrong side of the mall that I had wanted to. And where we have to go for stealing independence, I think it's right around that corner up there. But I wanted to come down here to the History Museum. Pick up this map marker. And conveniently enough, I have a player home here. We can go and sleep here tonight. Taking care of all the muties. Yep, and we can talk to the other Willow.
Another human with a death wish. Welcome to the mall, tourist.
Where the hell did you come from?
Nice to meet you too. I'm the sentry for Underworld, City of Ghouls, inside the museum. For a tourist, you're pretty clueless. My name's Willow, by the way.
Did you say a city of ghouls?
Sure did. Underworld. It's right inside the Museum of History, then through the Big Skull. Most of the residents ain't crazy about humans, but they'll settle to you, fix you up so long as your caps are good and you ain't a ghoul hater.
Definitely not a ghoul hater. So, you're crazy to stand out here. Aren't you afraid of the super mutants that I just, you know, kind of got rid of?
Those knuckle draggers? Nah, they don't bother us ghouls. Maybe they see us as kin or something, I don't know. Now there's other assholes.
Other assholes?
Yeah, you know, those humans like you. Well, maybe not like you, I don't know, but humans all the same. The Brotherhood of Steel guys with their testosterone and power armor. Those Psycho Talon Company mercs. Those other assholes.
Just for the record, there's a lot of women who don't have testosterone in the Brotherhood that use power armor. Just saying. And by the way, I'm not a tourist.
Come on, here you are in the mall of our nation's fine capital, taking in the sights, visiting the monuments. Face it, you're a tourist.
All right, I have to go now.
Till next time, sightseer.
Godosin says, you only running around with the Chinese assault rifle? Nope, I have 10mm submachine gun, Chinese assault rifle, hunting rifle, which I probably might want to rebind because I keep hitting 3, because that's what my rifle is in Fallout 4. I might want to rebind that. Combat shotgun and a sniper rifle. And as soon as I start putting some points into energy weapons, I'm going to start using a laser rifle. But my energy weapon skills kind of suck right now, so let's save before we go in here. Alright, so we're going to hop on in. And it's dark. So I have a little player home over here. We're just going to... I'm not going to go into Underworld proper yet, just because we don't really have time tonight. So this is... It's really dark in here. It's just called the museum. I don't know. Natural Museum. Underworld Home. That's the name of the box. The Underworld Home. It's very small, but it's a cool little place to come and crash here. There's a few supplies. I will take all the ammo since it doesn't weigh anything. And I think there's a My First Infirmary. I'm actually going to use that to heal up with. And there's a workbench. There's a fridge. I gotta start using this too. The mod that I have that lets you, it opens up the repair services menu. If I didn't have any objects to repair my gear with, I could use this and pay the caps. But I'm not gonna do that. I think I got rid of one of the wrong hunting rifles here. Hang on a second. Which of these is the one I have? Do some repair here. Wow, this is getting beat up. I think we're good. Let's just grab some sleep in our little awesome little bed here. Let's see. Let's do 10 hours. The game still crash if you repair stuff too fast? I'm assuming it does. That's why I'm not repairing stuff too fast. We have that here too. I'm going to leave this stuff here for now. I assume it does. And I'm not going to test it to find out. Yay, no tapeworm. Ah, British lady didn't work that time. I think Streamlabs is just broken. But yes, no tapeworm. No tapeworm. This is a tapeworm-free game. Thanks for those bits, Deckard. Or, I'm sorry, Mad Dog. You guys keep... Both you and Decker keep throwing those bits at me. I can't keep it straight. Thank you, Mad Dog. Not that I'm complaining. It's just I'm old and feeble and get easily confused. Yes, the stable genius. Exactly. There's a dead raider. Is this the station that has the barrels in it? I think it might be. Old man yelling at screen. Yes, because I got bored yelling at clouds. Well, now I yell at the game screen. Exactly. Ooh.
Damn it.
We just found a Chinese Army Special Operations Manual. Sneak increased by 2. Define old. Over 50. So my sneak is up to 31 now. That's pretty good.
For the record, I'm not having fun.
Cool. Yeah, somebody's been through here and killed these already. Over 50, I remember those days. Yeah, I'm living those days. It's just like yesterday to me. Day older than dirt. Your feet somewhere. Thought I was younger? Oh no. No, I am an old geezer. Oh. Nope. Nothing. Let's put it this way. When I used to go to bars at least once a year, I get asked for my ID to go in a bar because of the drinking age restrictions. And, at least once a year, a bouncer would apologize for reproofing me. Oh, I'm sorry, you're old. That kind of reaction. Yeah. I don't think that's going to happen these days. hey, Pax, how you doing? I don't feel so bad modding at 40 now, Pax says. You know, you should.
I'm not having fun.
Where are you? Oh, you're behind me. Hang on. No wonder Buttercup sounded like she was behind me. I had my headphones on the wrong way after the break. Stable genius. Yes, indeed, everyone. What the hell are all? Not see anybody. Did somebody come through here and kill all the raiders already? I don't understand. Oh, wait a minute. We did. We went out this way. We did all this. This is us. Yes. We did all this, I think. We didn't. Oh, God, I get so twisted around in these damn metro stations. Yes, we've come this way already. We went out that way. So we have to keep going. We basically just did a loop. We have to keep continuing this way, northbound. That's why they're all dead, because we killed them. Perpetarp. Okay, northbound Metro Central. Yeah, Metro Central's the one with all the ferals in it, I think. Let's make a save here before we get there. Well, the thing about... Oh, hello. No! The thing I find about getting old is, at least for me, I'll tell someone the same story 3 times. Like, you already told me this. Oh, I did? And that's bad, but then there's movies that you forget you watched, and it's like watching it for the first time. It's amazing. And my aunt used to joke about, when my aunt was still alive and in her 60s, she says, the best part about getting old is you get discounts. And she was very proud of that fact, that she got discounts. Alright, where are we? I can't really see very much. Kind of hard to see with all this blood on me. Oh, you had a combat shotgun. Uh-huh. Weapon repair kit, I'll take that. So I have a mod that adds weapon repair kits, just like in New Vegas. I have multiple ways to repair my gear. I actually think I meant to remove the weapon repair kit mod because I have all the tin cans and stuff, but it's too late now. It's in the load order, so I guess I gotta use them. Beer. I'll take one. What time is it? We just got up. It's too early to sleep. Look at all these wonderful tin cans. Okay. Right in mid pose. Oh, shit. She's... Oh, I'm sorry. Damn it.
Let's get out of here.
I thought she was a raider. She wasn't a raider. Oh, damn it. She was friendly, and I killed her. She was a friendly. Shit. Oh, no. I killed her. Oh, man. Look at all the stuff she had. I thought she was a raider. You monster. Yeah, she's from NPC's Travel. I thought she was a friggin' raider. But she had a plasma rifle. Oh, look at the stuff she's got. Holy shit. Yeah, Whoops is right. Damn. Surprised I didn't lose karma. Oh well, mine now. Sorry, ma'am. I really feel bad. She was just in here hanging out. I think she may have killed raiders. Because this is supposed to be closed. There's supposed to be raiders in here. Hey, Reaper, how you doing? Yeah, I think I did a bad. I did a bad thing. Definitely a bad thing. Oh, well. I did an oopsie. Yep. I killed a friendly. I just was not expecting to see her here. That's a mighty nice plasma rifle I got, though. Oh well, it happens. Nah, I'm not gonna reload.
She's just standing around.
Random NPC.
When there's plenty of action around. Sure, give me whatever you got.
I got a plasma rifle now. I'm not gonna reload.
Baby did a bad thing.
There she is. Thanks for those bits, Kelly. Appreciate it. I've come through here with NPC's Travel and see the Brotherhood have a patrol going through here. It's the weirdest thing. See them going through the metro, clearing a path of ferals and raiders. It's pretty awesome. I kind of forgot that there's... Oh!
Yeah, let's get to the action.
Yeah, I don't want you to wear that because you look pretty stupid.
Kid, what do you need?
I need you to give that back to me.
Sure. Give me whatever you got.
Put your combat helmet back on. There you go. Alright, I'm going to save after that, though. Oh, for a second, my weapon change sound sounded awfully, awfully muted. NPCs travel no matter what Fallout game gives the game much... Yeah, yeah. Or death, as you could, as you just saw. It also gives death. Hey, Jacko, Jacko, you trolling scammers. Good for you. How you doing? Yeah, you should troll scammers. The way that they troll us? Absolutely. You have my blessing to troll the scammers. Alright, door to Metro Central. Oh, dark. Yep, mall outpost. That's... Oh boy. Anything in here. There's another one down there. Is that it? What the hell is this one? Oh, hello, cop. Oh. What's my lockpick skill? Oh, 45. I don't have anything that's going to increase that, right? I guess we'll have to come back for that. No biggie. I don't know. I don't know if we're going to get too much to do Brian Wilkes tonight. We'll at least get it started, but we're going to be down here for a while yet. Can't get a lock on the other one there, so we'll go for you. Oh, that's awesome. That's awesome. The power of Cod compels you.
Over here. Yeah? You want some of this?
I think the trash can's the only thing that saved me. I will take those bobby pins, thank you. This station is going to be filled with barrels. Ghouls. Why did it have to be ghouls? Okay, there's one. Please don't be ferals again. I got news for you. It's ferals again.
That's
right, there's a second level. Let's go up there. I think we actually have to switch levels here. Hang on a minute. White line platforms, because I think this is northbound DuPont Station. I don't think that's what we want. Where's my map? It helps to have a map. Let's see. Yeah, DuPont, that's not what we want. We gotta go upstairs. We need to get on this line here that goes under the river. I think that we have to do that. We have to go upstairs where all the ghouls are. I love the metros in this game, though. I get lost, and I... Whoa! I did... He was standing right there. I didn't even see him. How about that? Got their attention, though. I do love the metros in this game, though.
I'll be sure to haunt this place.
There was an irradiated metro before the war? Yeah, that's... It's... Oh, jeez, I gotta heal up here.
Thought I heard something.
That was a really hot happening place before the war. The Irradiated District. Oh yeah, there's a Brotherhood sign up there. So, yeah, this is the game, the way the game normally wants you to go. But we're going bass-ackwards. Not a smart move. I hear you. Do you see him bouncing over Bittercup? Oh boy. I keep getting stuck on the stairs here. Oh shit. Did not want to do that. Got this one here too. Love that sniper rifle with the zooming. Zoomity zoom. See dilemma. Dilemma. Thanks for that follow. Welcome. And I'm about to get probably stomped by some ferals.
It's good to be out here. Damn.
There's one around here somewhere, but I don't know where. Where is he? Yeah. I love how they know exactly where they are, but I can't see shit. Oh, I knew that was gonna happen. Dog meat is unconscious. And that bitter cups just... Did you just like teleport up there? What the... You were down there. Holy Christmas. You alright there, bud? I'd say that took care of the feral problem. Oh man, oh man. It just works, everyone. It just works. Westbound Foggy Bottom. I think that's what we want. Westbound? Let's go this way. I think this is the one we want.
Bittercup took epic dodge.
Yes, she did. She absolutely did. Thanks, Mad Dog. Thanks for those biddies. Well, that's something you don't see every day. I seem to remember there being more ferals in there, but I'm okay that there's not. I'm very, very okay that there's not. Hey, Dan and Saber Wolf, how you doing? Alright, oh, Dean's Electronics, yes please. Sensor module, yes please. Let's see, what is that going to do for my repair skills? What are we at now? 60, that should not be another 2. Oh yes, I love it. Okay. Jericho, my friend.
Yeah, kid. What do you need? Sure. Give me whatever you got.
Carry these junk items, please. Dan and Sabro, thank you for that sub. Thank you for subscribing. I do appreciate that. Okay. 238, we're doing pretty good. Oh,
I'm getting bored.
I gave Jericho one of those necklaces from a raider that I looted, and he must have taken a fondness to it because he's wearing it. I see ghouls down here. You know, I haven't saved in a while. Oh, thanks, Dan. I appreciate that. Thank you for saying so. Goodbye. Oh, you have a friend. How am I missing you? How am I missing you? Damn it, game. Come on. This game has serious issues with how quickly it lets you switch weapons. How do you get the creation kit? You have to install the Bethesda.net launcher. And you install it from there. It's kind of hidden. I think you have to go under tools, and I think it's in that part. It's been ages since I've had to install it, but you need to install the Bethesda.net launcher on your PC and install it in the directory where your Fallout 4 game install is. Do not install it someplace different, because then it won't work. Talon Company Merc. Oh, that's right. I forgot her being here. Laser pistol. Bitter cup.
Oh, hey. I was just trying to think of a word that rhymes with glue.
Yeah, the Bethesda launcher, I'm pretty sure what it shows like when you first launch it, it's all games and stuff, but I think there's a setting for, there's an option for tools, and that's where both the Fallout 4 and the Skyrim Special Edition creation kits are.
Here. This is for you.
And then once you have it installed, you do not, contrary to what some people might tell you, you do not need to have the Bethesda.net launcher running. You can launch it right from the executable. I'd recommend making a either put it in your taskbar or make an alias on your desktop or something like that. But you absolutely do not need to have that awful Bethesda.net launcher thing running. You want to use the creation kit. Oh, we got rads here. Oh, rads are down here. Yeah, this is another area here I've run into random NPCs from NPCs Travel. Okay, I'll take that. Alright, down. Yeah, I came through here once. And that woman that I killed, she was down here. That adventurer, she was roaming around down to the end of these stairs here. And I almost shot her then. I didn't know who the hell she was. And today I actually shot her because I didn't know who the hell she was. Nothing back here. Right, just... You know, oh. I will take that tin can. There's nothing else. Nothing else. And this is also the area where I've seen seen the Brotherhood come through. But sure use them now. Very ominous. Anything down that way? Oh, we got raiders. Shit. That one hit. I crippled him. Yep, right leg crippled. Shit, stand still. Stop moving! Nope. Wasting a lot of ammo. There we go. That's better. I level up. Nice. Oh, here we go. not even gonna wait for me to get out of combat. 22 skill points. Holy Christmas. I think we're gonna have that many. Alright, I'm gonna bring energy weapons up to 32. Lockpick I want to bring up to 50, for sure. Science! Up to 50. Speech up to 60. I need to start putting some points into barter. My barter kind of sucks. So we're going to put the rest into barter. And, yes, I'm taking Strong Back. With Strong Back perk, you can carry 50 more pounds of equipment. I'm just going to do that. Even though I have a backpack and companions, I'm just going to go ahead and take Strong Back. You're hobbling too, it looks like. Well, so much for surprise. Another one down there too, I thought. You know, after that level up, let's save. I've never had the game just pause combat like that. That was interesting.
Yeah, yeah.
Die! Jericho. Die, die, fucking die! More of them. I think we gotta go this way.
Like that, you got...
Oh, there's another one over there. Carry weight's not 37. Who were you? Oh, another raider. You have. Oh, yes, we'll take that for sure. Doing alright there, Bittercup? We'll get you home to write that poetry. Don't you worry. Worry your pretty little head there. There will be plenty of time for poetry. I think we have to go that way. Let's go see what's out here, though. Foggy Bottom, where the hell is that? We need our wonderful map. I may just ditch the hunting rifle. Get back home.
This is lame.
It is not, Bittercup. Stop that. She's always so negative. What is it with her? Arlington Station. I want to say we want to keep going. Hmm. Okay, we are not there. We're not Metro Central. This map mod is not working at all. Because we're at Foggy Bottom, which isn't even on here. Yeah, I don't think I like this map very much.
This is lame.
So that says Arlington. I think we want to keep going that way up towards Arlington. Yeah, we do. We want to keep going this way. Kelly says, some praise for the Black Isle, Troika, Obsidian guys playing event. The vampire game? The VT? That the Vampire Masquerade? Bloodlines? Okay, yeah. Vampire Masquerade Bloodlines. First low humanity run. Surprised at how different the dialogue is. I am not familiar with that series at all. I know Gopher's been playing it. But I am absolutely not familiar with it in any way, shape, or form. Hello! Hey, Whiskey, how you doing, you bleacher creature? How you doing? Whoops. Take those. I'm not going to take all the... Actually, no, I will take all the Raider armor. I can sell all the things. Look at the size of this Wonder Glue. Oh, I just saw Quantum, too. That has got to be... giant size Wonder Glue right there. That's definitely the economy size. There's Quantum for Miss Sierra when we get to her. Okay, let's... The Flawed Gem, great writing. I guess I was actually thinking to start watching Gopher's playthrough. Because I know nothing about that series at all. Shotgun's okay. Let's bury you. Sniper rifle definitely needs some repair work. This thing wears down really quickly. Barrel. I could use that Raider armor, but that's okay. Okay. Save there. Found Foggy Bottom. Yeah, that's the way we want to go. Could go up and explore that station up there, but it's getting late. We got things to do. And I thought we'd be out of the metro by now, but Willow. I almost said Willow again. Bittercup's gonna haunt this place. Oh, yes, we have. Yeah, see, this is the way the game wants you to come this way, come running from that door there, and come up the hill and hit the tripwire, but we're not going the way the game wants us to. Oh, this is where the Mirelurks are, isn't it? Yes, it is. Yeah, I get really twisted around in here, too.
Hey!
Oh, hell!
You like that?
You are so dead.
Yeah, there's... Ignore the Mirelurks, everyone. We don't really need to deal with that. Oh, there's one. Shotgun time. We need to go this way. I remember you. I can just go through that way, right through the water, but Bittercup, we gotta have a talk. Damn. Yeah, we don't want to go that way. We want to go back the other way. Holy Jesus, there's Hunter Woods writing a novel. Got a question. How do you know why in the creation kit from Fallout 4 won't let me edit my mod? It's trying to say there's a custom interior that a mod add in, then I try to add anything like a custom workbench from a different mod. Peel in the creation kit. We probably trying to use an ESP as a master and you can't do that. That would be my guess. There he goes. Yeah, you used to be able to open up another mod and make a kind of do like a patch is what it sounds like you're trying to do. And it would just save your mod as make the mod you're modifying a master, or the other way around. You can't do that. Short of it, you can't do that anymore. They took that functionality out. Right around the same time, they introduced the ESL file format. So what you need to do is you need to make. Let's hang on a second here. You need to make the first mod. Make that an ESM file. You have to do that next edit. And then you can go to make that that mod an ESM and X edit. Give it an ESM flag and X edit. Then you can go back and do your changes, save your ESP. And then you have to go back in. Once all that's done, you have to go back, open both. You have to open both mods and X edit. You have to change the original mod back to an ESP, and then you have to change the master dependency on the patch. So
this is lame.
It's kind of a pain in the ass. That's why I don't do patches or anything like that. Oh, this is not where we want to be. We don't want to be here. Any particular DLC you're going to do before the others? I'm probably going to do Operation Anchorage first because it's my least favorite and get it out of the way. But I'm not going to do that for a long time yet. Oh, I'm already at full health. Yeah, based on that rather cryptic description, that's what it sounds like is happening. Yeah, it used to be you could just make a patch for a mod and it would just work. But yeah, you can't do that anymore because apparently I don't think people want to do that sort of thing anymore. So you have to do the X-Edit dance. And it's annoying. It's annoying as hell. We come out this way.
Thought I heard something.
Yeah, this is where we just came from. Okay. Raiders. Oh. Okay. Dead Mire Lurk. I don't remember where this is. I bet we got raiders that way. There's no doors down there. I'm definitely gonna do Operation Anchorage first. I don't know when I'm going to do it, though. People say, you can just go do it and get the power armor because you don't need training, but I'm gonna wait until I get the training. Probably. Until we do the Brotherhood thing and get the Actually, no, I take that back. I have a mod made by Gopher that, power armor training becomes a perk. And I actually think I can get that at level 10. That's not a door down there, right? If I'm at level 10 and I get I think I need a science and repair skill. I can take it as a perk. So I won't have to wait to do the Brotherhood thing. That's right, I think I have that installed again. remember more raiders in here at one point, but maybe not. I'm thinking of another metro tunnel. This is Arlington Utility. I think we're getting closer. Oh boy. There's another tripwire right here. I love this shotgun. I love my shotgun. Oh, Raider Cave in here. That's right. Yes, I remember this. This is really cool. Get this Raider Cave.
I really missed this.
Basically attached to the subway system. It's pretty cool. Well, you can download, it's called FO, if you look for FO4 Edit on Nexus, you can download it right from there. There, Hunter Woods. Yeah. Some people call it FO4 Edit or... FO3 Edit or whichever game. It's all essentially the same editor program. But depending on what game you're using it for, you might refer to it for the game or just X-Edit, which is kind of like a generic tag that covers all the games. I just say X-Edit because I use it for so many... I use it for this game, for Fallout 4, and for New Vegas, and I think I've used it a couple times for Skyrim. So, one application to rule them all. Yep, right there on the Nexus. You should be able to get it.
I'm getting bored.
Oh, bitter cop. All this looting and shooting isn't good enough for you, bitter cop. Where are they? I just saw somebody up. I want to hit you, Jericho. I think that one... This one was sitting... Oh, jeez. I can't really see with all this blood splattered. Guy was sitting in the chair shooting at me. Too lazy to get up and shoot at me. He was sitting right there in his chair. Let's eat some food to heal up. Oh, I don't want to drink that quantum. Oh, no, sorry, I don't. Need a little bit more than that. That's better. I'm going to stop collecting hunting rifles because I just don't need them. Do a little inventory maintenance. The street howitzer. I one-shot a super mutant with the shotgun tonight. I don't know how the hell I did it, but it just worked. I was amazed. Could not believe I did that. No, doesn't even have a legendary effect on it, go figure. Doesn't even have the Mutant Slayer's effect on it. Did I shoot him in the knee? Yes. He used to be a super mutant, like,
Yeah, kid. What do you need?
Virgil, till he took a shotgun shell to the knee.
Sure. Give me whatever you got.
Alright. Yeah, you're gonna take all these extra weapons here. I don't know. I wish the game showed you which weapons you had favored, because I have four hunting rifles. I have no idea which one of these is the one I've got favored. I'm assuming it's the one with the highest health, but I don't know. I don't know. Okay. Oh, that's good. That brings me...
Yeah. Let's get to the action.
Before we get to the action, we're going to make another save here. One second here, guys. Gotta poke at something on the other screen here. Ah, yes, we have the spam bots. Spam bots in the house.
Take him
down! This is shit!
With offers of buying subscribers and buying... What does it say? It's pretty funny. You want to become famous? Buy followers and Prime subs. Yes.
Good riddance.
Good riddance indeed to that spam bot. I think a lot of people are getting hit with those lately. This is where I don't remember where the hell I'm trying to go. At least they're not trying to sell me Viagra or tapeworm. Oh boy, dark.
I'm getting bored.
Yes, the joke's on you. Red's already famous, but for all the wrong reasons. Hello.
I'm glad that's.
Oh, it's 2 o'clock in the morning. No wonder they're all in bed. Sorry. Sorry, I disturbed your slumber. Hey. Hey, what's the saying goes? There's no such thing as bad publicity. Okay, that's empty, empty, empty. Nope, okay. Two and a half hours later, we haven't even gotten to meet Brian Wilkes yet. How about that? Right in the gut. Oh, dog meat. Damn it. Oh, who did that? Who took that shot? That was awesome. See, dog meat does not block my way, but he blocks my shots. I've yet to trip over him in a doorway, but boy, has he been getting in the way of my shots tonight. Yeah, permanent slumber. You won't have to be worried about getting up late. There's a rad roach. I'd like to know where the hell we are. Ooh, more sensor modules, yes please. Oh, it was Jericho with the chain smoking again. I guess this is, he's not doing it now. That half crouched pose while smoking, that must be the stealth smoking animation. Okay, I guess we have to go back this way? No. There's gotta be a way out up here. Hang on. There's no door here. No, there's no door. There's no way out. I think I should have turned left at Albuquerque. I'm sorry, Albuquerque, Bugs Bunny would say. Alright, let's backtrack here. Yeah, I've had a hard time getting out of this part before. Not going the right way. Cup's favorite path is dead end. Oh boy. But I'm bum. Hey! Should probably heal up some more. You know what? I'm just gonna use this impact. I hope we haven't been this way already. Oh, yeah, this is where we want to be, everybody. Yep. Yes, I believe it is. We should cross, I don't know what the name of the station is here, but it's basically the opposite end of where the entrance to our, Arlington National Cemetery. This is where we wanted to go. Yay. We're not going to go up top yet, though, because there's a whole buttload of raiders up there. We're just going to sneak across the other side over here, go back into the metro, and we're essentially at our subway base, which is exactly where we want to be. Because that's right near Girdershade, not Girdershade, Greyditch. Yeah, Arlington Wasteland Metro. And we should be seeing... Oh, let's put the light on here. Door to our little player home should be right down the corner here. Yep, here we go. Door to subway base. We made it. Outstanding, everybody. Alright. We can take a breather here. Let's go close the gate. Close the gate. There it is. All right. 4:19 a.m. Holy crap. We're gonna sleep in. Well rested. I don't think I have any other bobbleheads, right? No, I don't. No, just the three.
This is lame.
It is not lame. Oh, I did get intelligence. Really? Strength, intelligence, and medicine. Okay. Oh, that's right. We got the intelligence at Rivet City the last time around in the science lab. I remember now. So those bobbleheads will show up in all the player homes I have with the... bobblehead stand, including the Megaton House. They should be in the Megaton House. So they'll show up at the Underground Hideout. I think I have to go and activate the display there. Underground Hideout and the Mini Hideout Bunker in Springvale. Activate the display there, and they should show up. And that's empty. Alright. So we can head on outside here. And look at that. Look where we are. We came all that way. We're right here at our base and right below Greyditch. So let's go see if we can find Brian Wilkes. I still can't believe he didn't come over to force greet us when we were at the Super Duper Mart. Yeah, that's what I was afraid of. I didn't want to say anything because right where the hatch is, that's where Talon Company likes to ambush me half the time. And if you don't go to Greyditch for X amount of time, you'll actually run into a Wastelander that will come running to you and say, run for your life! I've had that happen once before. And say that the ants are burning Greyditch! Yeah, run! But, Brian Wilkes hasn't come out to say hello yet, so let's go say hello to him. I think this is the way. Come on. pick up this map marker. Okay. We'll have to go in there at some point. Let's see. Great itch. Say that there's sometimes raiders down that way, but maybe I'm thinking of someplace else. Is it over this way? Oh, hello, Bittercup. Aha, what?
I can't wait to see you bleed out.
Oh, it's just a poor little mole ratty. I don't see it on the compass yet. Let's go over this way. That up there. And that might be Fairfax. I'll find it. Just give me a second. There's a landmark that I'm looking for. I thought was near the Super Duper Mart. Is this it? Maybe this is it. Yeah, this is it. Here we are. Welcome to Gray Ditch. Yeah, there's the diner. I don't
you bleed on me.
Hit the antenna. Hit the antenna. This place bugs me. Oh boy. There he is. How come you didn't come and hunt me down? I hope you're not broken, because you're totally not moving or anything.
Those monsters, they're gonna get me.
Hey, Decker, you take care. Thanks for coming and hanging out for a while. It's good to see you. Thank you for all those biddies, and good luck with that new mod you got posted. And we will see you next time. You take care. Have a great slumber. What's the matter, kid? What are you talking about?
Those things. They keep coming. They scare me. Make it stop.
Let's see, we could do speech 100%, hey, okay, kid, calm down, it's gonna be okay, I promise. I'm a big, tough lady, can't you tell? It's gonna be okay, kid, I promise.
You won't leave me like all the other grown-ups. You can help me.
I'd like to help, but I need to know more about what's going on first.
Those big things, they're all over Great Itch, and they killed everyone. Please find my papa.
I love how you can shake him down for caps to help him. Like, this kid's got caps or anything. Although I think he does give you a key to a stash somewhere, though. I think there's a dumpster he gives you a key to if you go that route. Okay, what happened here?
It used to be kind of nice. No one bothered us there. I guess because we were so close to DC. There were 7 of us living there in tall, old brick houses. I think I'm the last one left. Those things took everyone else.
Did you know the others in town very well?
Nah. People don't like to stay long in Great Itch. The DC ruins aren't a great place to make a home, you know. In fact, Papa was talking about moving on soon. We've been here for maybe a year.
So who else lived in Great Itch?
Besides me and my papa, there was Doc Lesko, who stayed with us, and Will Brandis, and his mama and papa, too. I guess they're all gone now.
Now, let me ask you something else there, Mr. Brian.
All right. What is it?
Let's see. Can you tell me more about the things attacking Great Itch?
Well, they're big, ugly things that crawl around on 6 legs. They got huge teeth and skitter around grabbing everything in their path. My papa would always say they're fucking ants. Well, that's what he used to call them anyway. I just call them fire ants.
Is there any special way to hurt them?
My papa had a gun. He said it hurt those things. But he said they were the dumbest fucking ants he ever saw. He kept telling everyone to shoot for their antenna. Whatever that means.
Shoot for the antenna on the fucking ants. Got it. Have they always been around?
Nah. Those things started coming around only in the last few months. At first, they just crawled around outside our town. But later, they came into town. And, well, you know the rest.
Let me ask you something else.
Alright. What is it?
Let's see. Mind if I ask you about some of the people who lived here?
Nah, go ahead. It's just nice to talk to anyone about stuff at all.
Tell me about this Dr. Lesko, or Doc Lesko.
He was a strange man. He paid Papa some caps to help him build a shack and carry a bunch of junk into it. Papa called him an egghead, but his head was shaped regular, so I didn't get it.
Where did Dr. Lesko stay?
He spent all of his time in that shack, next door to my house. Every time I'd sneak in there, he'd be sitting at that funny-looking TV machine with the green words pushing buttons.
Believe it's called a terminal, Brian. Do you have any idea what Dr. Lesko was doing in Great Itch?
Nah, he was a nice man, but he never wanted to play with me very much, and we barely talked. All I know is he was all gone when the ants started showing up. I think they got him too.
Did Dr. Lesko have any weird stuff in his place? I'm not gonna say anything.
I don't know. All kinds of doohickeys. Boxes with lots of lights, some funny glass bottles. Oh wait, he had a big, clunky, shiny man too. That was kind of neat.
Yes, Doc Lesko. Yeah, doohickeys in a shiny metal man. Okay, about the other people from Grey Ditch.
Yeah?
Tell me about the Brandis family.
Well, there is Will. He was sort of my friend. And then there was his dad and his mom.
Where did the Brandises live?
Right across the street, actually. It was pretty swell having someone to hang out with so close by.
So you and Will were good friends?
Yeah. Will was super nice to me. He was like a year older than me, I think. He even shared his comic books with me. We explored pretty much every bit of Great Itch we could find. I think that's why the ants don't bother me. I have good hiding spots.
And one of those things, the wires that goes bzzz. I think he's had a couple of those, actually. How about Will's parents?
Well, his mom was nice, too. She was kind of quiet, but she always took care of me and my papa when we came over. I think she was sad that my mom was gone. Will's dad was... Well, I don't want to be mean, but he was kind of scary.
Will's dad was scary? How so?
He was like... always watching me and my dad real careful, like he didn't trust us or something. He always kept staring at us from the windows of his house and typing stuff into his TV box. Will said his dad was like an old soldier or something, but he didn't like doing that stuff, so he quit.
Yeah, Will's dad, I'm not going to do it tonight because I'm tired, it's very late, and only have X amount of time left. But Will's dad, read the terminal in their house. Will's dad is ex-Enclave, and he deserted. He didn't want to be in the Enclave anymore, so he's paranoid the Enclave is going to come and look for him and his family. They're hiding out here, more or less. Let's see.
Yeah?
Let's see. Where's your house, Brian?
Look for the house nearest to the billboard. That's sticking out of the ground. It's pretty close to the diner. You can't miss it.
All right, I'll go look for your father.
You will? Really? Thanks a whole lot. My house is the one closest to the huge sign and the old diner. Please, find my papa and make him come back.
Is there anything else you can do to help might save lives? Anything else you can do to help might help save lives?
You know, maybe this will help.
This is what I... Yes.
But Papa hid a bunch of stuff behind the old diner and a dumpster. He trusted me with the key and said it was for emergencies. But I bet he wouldn't mind you having it.
Okay. Is there anywhere you can hide while I search?
Well, there is the personal shelter next to the old diner. Papa always said to stay away from it. But I guess it's supposed to be safe. I'll head over there and wait inside. Hurry back.
Two hits, kid. Two hits.
My dog's on fire. My dog is on fire. Boom. And Jericho was not fazed one bit. Alright.
Stupid monsters. Can't get me in here.
Monster. Ah, there it is. I don't think I've ever gotten the key from him before. Ah. I'll take the frag grenades. Nice. Oh, yeah, I was going to save here, too. We better do that. Because it's been a while. Alright, let's go and say hello to these other fucking ants.
It's good to be out
here.
Yeah!
Hit him in the antenna. Antenna frenzy. We're definitely going to be going and seeing the outcasts after this. Oh, boy. Frenzied. This is one of my favorite screenshots in this game was Doc Hoff walking away from an explosion. Did he know something? Did he make the explosion? Whoops, I didn't want to do that.
I've got one.
I hear one. Oh, look at this! And you thought that Brahmin on buildings was just a Fallout 4 thing. You would be wrong about that.
And that sometimes it doesn't just work.
As I walk right in front of the fucking ant. It's a carpenter ant. Did you take care of that one up here, Jericho? You the man. Yeah, that is the Fallout 3 equivalent of a Brahmin on your building. Alright, so we're gonna have to go in there eventually. I remember there being quite a few down here.
Over okay. Here!
Or one.
Wait to see you later. I'm gonna fuck your shit up again. You new asshole.
Well, we have more down here. Might be. No, I think there's. I see three there. I hear some down below still, too. Dog me, where you going? Digital Partisan! Thank you for that sub. How are ya? Antagonizer FO4 DLC. How you doing, Digital Partisan? Good to see you. Thank you for that sub. How you been? Uh-oh. Oh, See, I one-shotted the dam. I'm on fire. 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 Callie said, I passed him on the road at the Temple of the Union, heard gunfire, turned around to see the explosion, him walking away. Yeah, he caused it. Or raiders did to try to take him out. I'm super busy, barely time for games or anything else. I hear ya. Oh, Jesus. Alright, I always end up going through stim packs here. We've got to be almost done with these. Oh, that car's gonna explode too. Yep. Whoops. Did you like that there, Bittercup? If you say this is boring or lame, you're fired. Okay. I think that's enough. I think we did it all. All the fucking ants. Alright, let's do a couple things here first. Let's save. And then we'll go into Brian's house. I think this is... No, I hear another one. Son of a bitch. You back here? I think you're back here. Yep, you're back here. Damn. Alright, we're gonna go back to the long-range weapon. Thank you, companions. Okay. Now I think we can go into Brian's house. Let me check this mailbox. Empty. Is this Brian's house? Brandis is. That's the Brandis' house. Let's go in here anyway. I think one of the houses had at the minute, maybe. There's John Henry Eden. I'm not going to take everything. I'll take the bobby pins for sure. I think... Yeah, this is Brandis' house in the toolbox behind the fridge. There's a pistol. And some rounds. And he mentions that... one of those terminal entries. I'll show you guys. I'm not going to go through and read them. Lock this. But yeah, Mr. Brandis was on the lam from the Enclave. I believe he deserted. And was paranoid that they were out looking for him.
America's children live in a terrifying, meaningless existence. There is no hope, no happiness. That changes right here, right now. From this moment onward, the children of this great nation are its highest priority. The Enclave will restore every American school, reinstate every youth program, and offer counseling and financial assistance to any family in need. We will match up the destitute orphan children of the Capital Wasteland with qualified, eligible adults.
There we go. Hey, Candu, how you doing?
Build the American family. As it was.
Yeah, so one of these... Yeah, I can't believe... I'm just going to read, like, this first one to give you an idea. I can't believe I went through all that trouble to leave Navarro and make my way across the country just to get stuck in this shithole. I'll be damned if I'm going to die here. Now that we're cut off from Lesko and Wilkes, I think we're on our own. The damn ants keep trying to find a way into the house. Even as I type this, I can hear them scraping at the walls looking for a way through. And how long, much longer we can last. And I think this is... Whoops. Yeah, finally found a quiet place for my family. One of these he talks about... Yeah, he talks about Henry Eden. He talks about leaving the, It's hard to talk over that. Not that I mind it. He talks about, 75, damn. Putting the gun behind the fridge. So, whoops. Yeah, unlike some games, when you get locked out of a Fallout 3, you're locked out for good. Yep. We can sell that.
Come on, let's get moving.
All right, let's make another save here. Oh.
I'm not having fun.
See? Blowing up cars, ants that set shit on fire, you're not having fun, Bittercup. Oh boy. Yeah, Brian's house is over right here. Go to Brian's house. Yeah, see, there's his. That's what I was. Okay, there's ants, but they're dead. Chat key. Gonna be to Dr. Lesko's house. Oh, that's right. This is a good place to get your first Chinese assault rifle. Except I went and got mine from the dead super mutant. Well, he wasn't dead when I got there. At Germantown Police Station. It's just bottles. I keep forgetting I'm not using the mod that refills the bottles with water, so I don't need the bottles, actually. 5mm rounds. Teddy bear. I'm just gonna leave those. You know what? I can sell that. I think we might do. Let's take a look at the map here. We're definitely not gonna finish this quest tonight, so. We'll have to go say hello to Dr. Lesko next time, because I'm gonna have to quit here pretty damn soon. So I'm gonna go up and say hello to Moira. So the shiny metal man is gone, apparently. That's not here. Really? They both have a leather belt. One has an iron, one has a tire iron. Okay. Dr. Lesko's password. Oh, this is... I like this recording. We will listen to that, because... Private personal notes. Alright, let's listen to this recording, because it's pretty funny. Dr. Lesko's password recording.
This could be the fifth time I've forgotten the code to my desktop terminal. I really must learn to be more organized. The password for my terminal is Formicidae. How hard could that be for me to remember? Note to self, destroy this holotape as soon as move to new lab is complete.
Can you just take you back, Brian? Oh yeah, yeah, we talked to Brian, we got the quest, I got a key for the, trash dumpster in back of the diner that had laser pistol and some stim packs in it. All good, although I do need to repair some gear here. Let's take care of that. Yeah, for the first time since I started playing this game again, he has not come out to force greet me at the Super Duper Mart. We had to come to him. He was just kind of standing there. I actually thought he was broken, but nope. I guess he was just scared. We're going to repair it with that. That's good. Now we'll condense that down. Okay. All right, let's take
stay standing long enough for us to leave
the terminal. Alright, activate science. There is no science robot to activate. Pod empty. Science robot command input. Out of range. Personal notes. Please do not access without permission. Sorry, Doc. I'm not gonna read this now. Let's see. Where did I go wrong? Batch 827 is a complete failure. I must return to my original formulas and begin the process all over again. Perhaps the pressure of working in these conditions without proper laboratory equipment is to blame. Perhaps I simply didn't splice the correct genetic instructions, or perhaps I'm fatigued. Whatever the case may be, A27 is proving to be a disaster. I must introduce a new formula soon, or I may not be alive to see my hypothesis come to fruition. Sample location discovered. Investigate Marigold Station and remove... Okay, we just got that update. I found the perfect specimen for my experiments inside Marigold Station. I've set up shop underground for now while I prepare the experiment. All I need is a bit of last-minute programming on my robot and it will be ready to perform the delicate injections. Soon I will prove to everyone that my formula is a viable alternative to the destruction of these misunderstood beings. Yeah, how'd that work out? Dangers. I realize the dangers involved in tampering with nature. I've heard the rhetoric in Hoopla about playing God. However, I'm determined to reduce these poor things back to their original state when they were harmless. Only through genetic recoding is this possible. All that is needed is a proper test subject. My search continues as I tweak the formula. And that's it. So, we just got the update. Go to West Marigold Station, which we've actually already... Oh, it shows us... Yeah, West Marigold Station. Investigate West Marigold Station and remove the source of the fire. Oh, we have to go deliver the bad news to Brian. Let's go do that first. Oh, Brian.
It's kind of hard to breathe in this thing. I hope you have good news for me. I really do.
Not exactly, kid.
Come on, tell me already.
I think I have some bad news for you, Brian.
Oh, no. What happened?
Sorry, Brian, but your father's dead.
He's dead? I guess I already knew. Besides, I'm too tired to cry anymore.
I probably should have chosen, sorry, kid, your old man's ant food. Let's see. Clear on, no, we're just gonna let him stay here. I'll stop whatever this started, I promise. I'll stop whatever started this, I promise you.
You gotta stop it, so this can't happen to anyone else's family ever again. I wish I had met you a long time ago. And then maybe my dad would still be alive. Thanks for doing all this. I'm feeling better now that you're here.
Alright, I have to go now.
Be careful, or those things might get you.
Okay, you, take care there, kid. We'll be back in touch. Alright, we're not going to be able to finish this tonight, because I'm going to have to wrap up here very shortly. So what I think we'll do, how close are we to, No, we're not that far. Let's head up to the mini hideout. We'll just walk up there. We'll go by foot. I think we get out this way. We'll go up to the mini hideout and we'll wrap things up there. Because I have a quantum I got to put in the storage, so... And I have a bunch of stuff. Maybe I can sell the Myrna off stream. Myrna. Oh boy. That's the first time I've done that. Moira! I've called Rivet City, I've called Diamond City, but I've never called Moira Myrna. There's a first. I mean, Subway House is closer, but it won't take long to get up to the up to Springvale. Yes, we're gonna go to Diamond City and sell some shit to Myrna, everybody. And there's the Wobbly Mountains! Yay! Uh-oh, what was that? I thought that was one of the cars of death like in Fallout 4. The random cars that you just nudge into and next thing you know you're dead. Uh-oh, who are we shooting at here? Is that a Yaogwai? Holy Jesus, it is. Where did you come from? Very long walk to Diamond City indeed. Might take a few years, actually. Might take a very long time. hopefully that's all we're gonna run into. Yeah, I think I may actually go off off stream too, go over to the Outcast and get some more ammo from them. Because I don't know when we'll be able to stream this again. Uh-oh. There's gunfire here. There were bullets whizzing past my head. I know not from whence they came. Cheer up, Jericho, we're home. There's old Deputy Weld. Pretty cool. There's Doc Hoff again. Mad Dogger says, you'll appreciate this. I took Doom's 223 pistol. Alright, somebody's shooting at us here. Added Rachel, named Legendary, to a container near Curry's Vault. Oh, cool.
I hate it here.
Alright, I just saw something on... Yeah, there's something going on down here by my house. Who is shooting at my house? There's a frick... That's the friendly Yaogwai. Yes, that's the scavenger Yaogwai.
Hello again.
Those raiders strapped me with explosives. You've got to help me.
Oh boy. Attempt to disarm? Do I... I guess attempt to disarm? Yeah, it might not work out. Nope. Sorry, I tried. Oh. I tried. You're the, and the, I promise not to kill you people. Yeah, this is the scavenger that has the Yaogwai with him. I want to make a point not to kill them. Kill that poor woman in the metro. I am having second thoughts about living in this neighborhood. There's a lot of violence that's been going on my front lawn here lately. I don't understand that. Alright, do I have any dirty waters? I do. Two. Okay, cool. Alright. We... Very important thing to do to end the stream on. Important note. And that is to add my Nuka-Cola Quantum to the collection here. So we have nine for Miss Sierra. And that's going to do it for tonight, boys and girls. Let me make a save here. We're going to wrap things up back. Seems like we either start a stream or end a stream here. Let me just switch sources here. And we will... wrap things up here. But yeah, that was fun. I was not expecting to be streaming Fallout 3 this soon, but I actually had the opportunity tonight, so. Spoke at the thing there. But yeah, that was a lot of fun. I'm really, really enjoying playing this game again. Hunter Woods, one more question. That commentary terminal to use the player home mod. Easy to create custom script for a vendor. Oh, you mean the commissary? Yes. Yeah, you have to set up an NPC first, though. You set up an NPC as a vendor. What I would suggest doing, what I did, and it's the way I did it is exactly how it was set up for the commissary terminals for the Lonesome Road DLC in New Vegas. Set up a new cell with just the vendor in it. Set up the vendor chest. Set up a vendor faction. Just how you would do a normal vendor setup. And the terminal is just an activator. There's a script that opens. It's basically just a few lines, I think. I can't remember exactly what it is offhand. All it does is open up the barter menu. And that's it. So, that's how you do it. I'm not going to take his Annie. We haven't gotten that far yet, can't you? We haven't even gone into the station yet. Don't you worry. We'll be taking care of Brian. We just got there. We just cleared the ants and got the quest, the update to go into the station. We haven't got that far yet. So don't you worry. Brian's going to get a home. We're not going to sell him the slavers. But I got to quit. I got to go to bed. So that's going to wrap it up here tonight, guys. Oh, I'm sorry. Sorry, Candy. I can't tell who you guys are talking to. Oh, I see. Kelly's saying, my current character hasn't finished dealing with Brian. She's waiting to sell him to the slavers. Ah, yeah. See, you're going that route. You're going that route. I actually keep saying one of these days I'm going to play as inside with the slavers, and I never do. I just can't bring myself to do it, to be a meanie. But one of these days I'm actually going to play an evil character so I don't have to cheat to get Jericho as a companion. It will happen. It will happen. But yeah, it's time to go. Time to say goodnight. You guys have a great night. Thank you all for stopping in and hanging out tonight. Thank you for all the new follows, all the subs, all the bits. And you guys keep showing up while I play these goofy games on the internet. And it's a lot of fun. And yeah, you guys take care. Have a great rest of your week. Stream schedule for the rest of the week. We'll be doing the Friday stream, the usual Fallout Friday stream. We'll continue the Railroad playthrough on that. I'm not going to be in town. I'll be out of town for the weekend, so there will be no weekend streams. I'm hoping I can have a Fallout 4 stream on Thursday, but I don't know yet. How the next two days go will kind of determine that. Definitely a Fallout 4 stream on Friday, potentially Fallout 4 on Thursday, but nothing over the weekend because I won't be here.
We just come for the tape where I'm betting pool.
Well, your odds aren't going to be too good in Fallout 3, Mad Dog, but thank you for those bits. Thursday or Friday, yeah, I think your odds are going to grow exponentially. So, but thank you for those bits. Thanks, everyone. Take care, Kelly. You take care of yourself. Have a good night. Everyone, stay safe, stay healthy, stay sane as much as humanly possible, or not humanly possible if you're a synth. Uh-huh. But, yeah, it's time for me to go get ready for the bed thing. I'm tired. You guys have a great night. Have a great week. Definitely see you Friday. Hopefully see you Thursday, but if not, we'll see you Friday. Have a great night, everybody.